So let's look at this problem that has both percents and dosages in the problem. So an adult weighing 155 pounds, we want to know how many vitamin D3 capsules would contain a lethal dose. We have some information here about vitamin D3. The lethal dose is 37 milligram per kilogram, and we have to make sure that we understand milligrams of the vitamin D3 and kilograms of body weight here. Just like any dose is going to be the amount of medicine per body weight. Then we have the percent. Let me add one piece to the percent here. The percent is mass percent. And then one capsule weighs 0.60 grams. So we want to know how many capsules. So with this problem, I want you first to try it without watching the rest of this video. But if you have already tried it, because you've paused and you tried it and you came back, then look at your work really quickly and see if you have labels on everything. So what I mean by that is, does your 37 milligrams have anything after the word, after the unit milligram? Or did you just write 37 milligrams? Does your 155 pounds have anything after the pounds, or do you just have that there? Because there's a lot of ways actually to solve this problem incorrectly with still canceling all of your units, and you think that it's correct. So, let me. So here's your answer. So you can check to see if you got the right answer. If you didn't get the right answer, let's work it out. So I have some conversions. Let's figure out where we're going to start our dimensional analysis. Where are we going to end? What's our unknown? And then I advise writing conversions out as equalities, not as fractions, because that really helps a lot of students figure out how to place everything in dimensional analysis correctly. So it's best to start with something that's a single unit if you can. So if we look at our LD-50, it's got two units. A percent is always going to have two units, it's going to be two pieces, like a subtraction. And then capsule and grams, they're connected to each other. So these are all conversions here. So not a great place to start. The best place to start is going to be the thing that's directly related to the answer. So if we want to know, the unknown is how many capsules. That's what we're looking for, number of capsules. It doesn't really have a unit, it's just a number of capsules. The best way to relate that back to the question is saying how many capsules for a 155 pound adult, right? So that is a your unknown and your start are going to be directly related. You can use it in a very short, quick question. How many capsules for what? How many capsules for 155 pounds? Now we're going to be specific here. We need to say body weight. I'm going to say BW for body weight, just so I don't have to write the words body weight over and over. So let's turn some of our information into conversions here. So our LD50 conversion is going to be 37 milligrams. Now, that is going to be milligrams of something because we cannot just say 37 milligrams equals 1 kilogram here because that's not true. That's not a true statement. It's not 1 kilogram is 37 milligrams for everything all the time. It's specifically our vitamin D and our body weight. And that's important because you can cancel out pounds with milligrams if you go through a gram conversion and then you wind up not doing the correct conversions, and you can wind up getting the wrong answer. And when we're talking about dosage problems, getting the wrong answer could mean overdosing or underdosing a patient. So we want to make sure we're getting these right. So be very specific in unit of what. And so our next one, our percent. Percents are always part out of the whole. So what I like to do is assume 100 of the whole. So if we have our number of percent here, 0.0042, that's going to be whatever our part is. And then we can set it equal to 100 of whatever the whole is. And you can do this for all percentages. Any number in front of the percent sign, we can say, oh, that's an amount of the part. It's equal to 100 of the whole. It gets rid of the whole percent sign. It gets rid of the times 100 or out of 100. And here we want to identify what is our part and what is our whole. So our part here, the interesting thing in the capsule is vitamin D. And the whole thing is the capsule. But that's just the description. We also need to decide on the unit. Now, when I have mass, that means I can use milligrams or grams for this problem. If we look at here, we have capsules and grams, so maybe we want to use grams here. We also have milligrams of vitamin D, so we can use milligrams. It doesn't really matter which you use. You will have to use another conversion to connect them. So let's just use milligrams since that's what we have already written in the conversion. So I'm going to say 0.0042 milligrams of vitamin D is equal to 100 milligrams of capsule. It has to be the same unit on both sides for a mass conversion. You may have mass volume conversions, and those will be different units on either side. So there's another conversion. Then we have our capsule. And when I say a capsule weighs, I can just say one capsule equals 0.60 grams. And that is grams of the capsule. It's not in one capsule, there's 0.60 grams of vitamin D. That's not what that statement means. It's the whole capsule is 0.60 grams, and that contains vitamin D, other oils, the capsule coating, the whole thing, that's how much that weighs. So these are the conversions that are given to us. Let's figure out if we need any additional conversions to make this complete. Now, what I like to do is put my finger on my starting unit and see if I can go through all of my conversions without picking my finger up and bounce back to my unknown unit. Or you can go from your unknown to your start if you get stuck on the first direction. Let's start with the first direction. Pounds of body weight. Already I see a problem. I have no pounds of body weight anywhere. So we can skip that and we can start with capsules. Or if you're looking like, oh, body weight in kilograms, body weight in pounds, I need a conversion for that. Let's pretend we don't see that for a second. Let's start with capsules. So if we get stuck going the first way, we can go the back way, the back route. So capsules here, I have capsules here with no unit, just number of capsules. That's directly connected to grams of capsule. Well, I don't have grams of capsule anywhere, but I do have milligrams of capsule. And so you should know a conversion from gram to milligram. Either you know 1,000 milligrams equals a gram, or maybe you know a milligram is 10 to the negative 3 grams, or maybe you know that a milligram is 0.001 gram. Whatever you have memorized, just use that. And then these are all going to be for capsules. Just going to abbreviate as cap here. So again, we're labeling what everything is. So I go from number of capsules to grams of capsule, grams of capsule to milligram of capsule, milligram of capsule to milligram of vitamin D, milligram of vitamin D to kilogram of body weight. So now I realize, oh, I need to connect kilogram of body weight to pounds of body weight, and I have a conversion for that. It is 2.205 pounds equals 1 kilogram. And of course, we want to add in our specific here, body weight. So we have all the conversions that we need now because we can connect the start and the unknown without picking up our finger. So pounds of body weight connect to kilograms of body weight. Kilograms of body weight connect to milligrams of vitamin D. Milligrams of vitamin D connect to milligrams of capsule. Milligrams of capsule connect to grams of capsule. Grams of capsule connect to capsules by themselves, and that is what I want. You cannot cancel, you can't connect kilograms of body weight to kilograms of capsule, for example. So Make sure that your descriptors are common with the things you're trying to connect here. So let's, we can set this up now. We have 155 pounds, and I'm going to put the description on underneath it to make some space here. Now, however you do your dimensional analysis may be different depending on your instructor or depending on your aesthetic preference. I use the train tracks because I think it gives me more space and I like the neatness of it. So every time I cross over a line like this, that is multiplication. It's just the same as saying, like, this fraction is multiplied by this fraction, but instead of putting an X and a space in between them, I'm just like putting them right next to each other with a line in between. So this is like the same as an X saying we're going to multiply this fraction by this next fraction. So we're going to cancel pounds of body weight. We have a conversion pounds of body weight here. So we're going to take the pounds of body weight and then the number that comes with it on the bottom. Then whatever it's equal to is what goes on top for any dimensional analysis. For any dimensional analysis, two things that are equal to each other can go on top of each other. Notice we cancel pounds of body weight with pounds of body weight. I'm not canceling pounds of body weight with pounds of medicine or pounds of capsules or pounds of vitamin D. Next, we have kilograms of body weight. So we find another conversion. Here's kilograms of body weight related to milligrams of vitamin D. So we're going to use that. The number that goes with the kilograms of body weight in the conversion is one. So that's the number I'm going to put in front of the kilograms of body weight in my dimensional analysis. Whatever it's equal to is going to go on top. Then I can cancel out kilograms of body weight. Now, if I stop here, I have milligrams of vitamin D. The question's asking me for whole capsules, so we have to keep going. Next, I have milligrams of vitamin D connected to milligrams of capsule. Now, you might hear use a milligram of vitamin D to gram of vitamin D conversion, and then gram here and gram here, right? So you're going to use the same conversions, just the order might be a little bit different depending on what you decided your percent was going to be. If your percent's in grams, your order is going to be opposite for the next two. If I want to have milligrams of vitamin D cancel, I need to have 0.0042 milligrams of vitamin D on the bottom to cancel that. Whatever it is equal to, 100 milligrams a capsule, that goes on top. Now I cancel out milligrams of vitamin D with milligrams of vitamin D. Has to be the same thing to cancel. Next, I have milligrams of capsule, so I can use milligram of capsule on the bottom. Whatever conversion you're using, just make sure you stick to those numbers. That's why I recommend writing it out like this first so that you can stay organized. Milligrams of capsule cancels milligrams of capsule. Milligram of vitamin D does not cancel with milligrams of capsule, so be careful. It has to be the same exact thing. So milligrams of capsule cancels milligrams of capsule. Now I have grams of capsule. We want to cancel grams of capsule out. And here I have 0.60 grams of capsule equals one capsule. So I'm going to put the 0.60 grams of capsule on the bottom and just put one capsule on the top. Now I'm going to set that equal because that's where I want to end. I want to know how many number of capsules, no unit. So I'm done. So every time I have something on the bottom of the fraction, I'm going to divide it. And every time I have something on the top of the fraction, it's going to get multiplied. And when you do that math, rounding to the nearest whole number of capsules, because it's asking about whole number of capsules, you would get 103. Wait, so sorry, 103,211 capsules. Reach out to me or your instructor if you have questions about this, but I hope that this